Good morning, children. I hope you're all following the videos. And I have got the tremendous response from you. Many of you are sending me those answer sheets, that work what you have done. It's very good. And you follow the same continuously. Still some of this, especially some boys are not following the videos. So please, every student of 9th standard should follow the videos which are sending by the subject teachers compulsory. Okay? And we are discussing about the diversity of the living organisms. And in that, about the classification we have already discussed. And also, we have discussed about the three kingdoms, that is Monera kingdom, Protista kingdom, as well as the Mycota kingdom. Today we are going to discuss about the another kingdom, and it is a second biggest kingdom of the living organism, so living world, and that is the kingdom Plantae. Kingdom Plantae. It is exclusively for plants, and the diversity of the plants is entirely different from all other kingdoms. And these are divided, these are classified, the plants are classified based on their structure, shape, and metabolic activities, and some other factors based on all those. Let us discuss about that. And this Plantae kingdom, particularly. Basically, as well as broadly classified into two groups. That is cryptogams and the phanerogams. Cryptogams and phanerogams. These are the two groups the total plants have been classified. Cryptogams, the plants which cannot bear the flowers. Non-flowering plants. As well as seed non-flowering plants, no seeds are present. No seeds are born. Okay, so these are completely non-flowering plants, and no seeds will be there. Without seeds, other plants, the plants will be developing in a different methods that we will discuss later. Okay, and the phanerogams, these are the plants which are flowering plants. These bear the flowers, and also seeds are present, seed bearing plants. Seeds are producing and flowers are producing in these plants. So this, based on these two characteristics, the total Plantae kingdom has been classified into two types, cryptogams and phanerogams. Let us learn about the cryptogams. As I told you that cryptogams are the plants which are not having the flowers, not bearing the flowers, and no seeds are presented there. But based on their body structure, and the place where they live, and are showing some differentiations or difference between them, these cryptogams have been classified into three types once again. The three types. The first one is Thallophyta, bryophyta. Third one is pteridophyta. These are the three types of cryptogams: thallophyta, bryophyta, pteridophyta. Pteridophyta, the sound should come. Pteridophyta, okay. P is silent in this. These are all the Greek words I told you, no? Those are. And that's why the P is silent here. It's pronounced as a pteridophyta. Okay. So, based on their body structure and these and places they located, or and also their body parts and some differences, based on those all, these cryptogams are classified into three types. That is the thallophyta, bryophyta, as well as the pteridophyta. Let us learn about the thallophyta. Thallophyta, their body is like a long strip-like structure. Long strip-like structure. Like a measuring tape. You know that? Like a measuring, the tailoring shop, you can find the measuring tape. And this body structure is like a measuring tape, the thallophyta. And this body, this type of structure, body structure is called as thallus. This type of body structure is called as thallus. So, the name is given as a thallophyta. And these are all multicellular organisms. Chlorophyll is presented there. These are all completely autotrophic organisms. Autotrophic organisms means the organisms which can prepare their own food by using the chlorophyll. That is the photosynthesis. Already in the lower classes you have got it. Photosynthesis is the process of preparing food by the plants by using the inorganic materials like carbon dioxide and water. In the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll, they convert the inorganic material into organic matter, that is carbohydrates. This total phenomena is called as photosynthesis. Okay, so these all having the chlorophyll, so they prepare their own food. And these are showing the autotrophic nutrition completely. And these are all completely aquatic plants, means live in water, completely live in water. Either may be marine water, that is sea and oceanic water, or may be fresh water, that is rivers, canals, ponds, lakes. Fresh water will be presented, rivers, canals, ponds, lakes. Marine water is present, that means salt water is presented in the seas and oceans. So, these organisms, both they live in the marine water as well as in the fresh water. But these are all completely aquatic in nature, that means water plants. Okay, and the examples of this thallophyta are okay. Afterwards, I will give the examples for this. So, based on this one, this body structure and the autotrophic nutrition, and also some other category, these thallophyta organisms are. Class again furtherly classified into two types, that is algae, multicellular algae. Algae we have got in the earlier also in the Protista kingdom. Those are unicellular algae and these are multicellular algae. Okay, multicellular algae. Multicellular algae as well as lichens. There are the two types of organism, plants we can find in this category, that is thallophyta. Algae, multicellular algae, these are almost green in color, sorry, chlorophyll is presented there. Because of the chlorophyll present, some of them are green in color. And these are based on that color of the body, based on the color of the body of the plant, these algae are classified into three types once again. Green algae, red algae, brown algae. Green algae, red algae, brown algae. Okay. Okay. So green algae, the plants which are presented, the algae, the multicellular algae which is belong to the thallophyta, that is presented in green color because of the chlorophyll is presented there. Chlorophyll, a green color pigment which give color to the plant. Chlorophyll is presented there so that the green algae are green in color. Chlorophyll is presented here. The color pigment is chlorophyll. The example for the green algae are Spirogyra, Spirogyra, Eulothrix, Chlamydomonas, are the best examples for the green algae completely. Okay, this is the chlorophyll is presented there in the green algae. Next, red algae. These are the red in color. Of course, remember in this red algae, even the brown algae also, chlorophyll is presented. Here, chlorophyll not only giving color to the plant, but it is also useful for preparing the food material. It is participating in the photosynthesis. So that's why here in this also chlorophyll is presented. Red algae, brown algae also chlorophyll is presented there. But the amount of the chlorophyll is dominated by the color pigment of this algae. So that their color will be different. Okay. So red algae is having the picoerythrin as a color pigment. Picoerythrin as a color pigment, so it is a red color. Red sea, you might be heard about that one. That is because of the red sea is called as a red sea, because of the red algae is presented in the red sea. The total surface of the red sea is covered by red algae. That's why the water is appears like a red color. So it is a red algae, red sea. Okay. So the picoerythrin is the color pigment here. Though there is a chlorophyll. Chlorophyll is useful for here. Chlorophyll is useful for only photosynthesis process. But the color of the these plants are given by the picoerythrin. Okay. The example for this one is Selaginella. Next one, brown algae. In this also, brown color pigment is presented here more than the chlorophyll. That's why this color will be given as a brown color. That is picocyanin. Is the color of the pigment, color of this plant, sorry, color pigment of this plant. So the brown color is given here. Okay. The examples for these two, I will tell you in the next video compulsorily. Okay, these are the green algae, red algae, as well as the brown algae. Examples will be given in the next video. Okay. Next one is lichens. This is a kind of organisms where algae and fungi are combinedly living together. Here one important feature you have to identify here, that is symbiosis. Symbiosis is the feature of the organisms. Two different organisms live together for the mutual benefit. Live together for the mutual benefit. That means that one organism may be protected by the other organism, and the other organism will be providing food to that organism, second organism. That is the mutual cooperation between the two organisms. One example I tell you. Suppose if you take the groundnut plant, the root system of the groundnut plant is a taproot system, and they have the primary roots, secondary roots like this. And where the secondary roots are joining with the primary root, there some blisters like structures will be formed. and these are called as root nodules. If you take the root nodule, this blister like structure, see under the microscope, you might be finding a kind of bacteria is living in these blisters, in these nodules. This bacteria is called as rhizobium bacteria. Rhizobium bacteria. It means that this rhizobium bacteria is taking shelter in the root system of the leguminous, that groundnut plant. So why it is taking shelter there? Because the groundnut plant is providing shelter as well as food to the rhizobium bacteria in its root nodules. In back, this rhizobium bacteria is providing nitrogen to this plant, because this groundnut plant, of course leguminous plants cannot absorb the atmospheric nitrogen directly. So this bacteria will absorb the atmospheric nitrogen directly, convert that atmospheric nitrogen into nitrogen salts, that is nitrites and nitrates. These two together called as nitrogen salts, and these nitrogen salts are useful for the growth and development of this plant. So here the plant is benefiting by the nitrogen, and the rhizobium bacteria also benefiting by taking shelter and food from the plant. So both the organisms are living together for a mutual benefit. This kind of phenomena is called as symbiosis. In the plants we can find in this one. Here the lichens also, some people will say that lichens, both are correct only. Lichens also show the symbiotic nutrition, symbiotic feature. In this algae and fungi living together, fungi will protect the algae and algae will prepare the food to the fungi. Food, prepare the food and provide it to the fungi. Both of them are living together for a mutual benefit. This is the best example for the symbiotic nutrition. Okay, lichens. These are all comes under the category of that green algae, red algae, brown algae for multicellular algae. Lichens, that is a fungi and algae together living, that is both of them are belong to the category called as thallophyta. Okay, and the next class, next video, we are going to discuss about the bryophyta as well as the pteridophyta. Okay, I hope you understood. You observe the video once or twice compulsorily, and this symbiosis, understood the symbiosis, and examples for this red algae, brown algae will be given in the next video compulsory. Okay, thank you very much.